Hello friends, welcome to the point. In this session, we are learning about number system. In this number system part 2, let's learn how to find the unit digit when we have a larger powers or index. First of all, what is this unit digit? Consider a number. Let's take a number 456. In this given number, 6 is at 1's place, 5 is at 10's place and 4 is at 100 place. So we call it as 456. So this 1's place number is called as unit digit. Let's write the power of a numbers. 2 power 1 is 2 and 2 power 2 is 4. 2 power 3 is 8 and 2 to the power of 4 is 16. And if you see 2 power 5, it is nothing but 32. So where the unit digit of the number is 2 and 2 power 6 is 64, unit digit is 4. And 2 power 7 is 128, 2 power 8 is 256. So if you observe here, the unit digit 82486 and 2486, it goes on repeating. Let's check for the other values. 2 power 9, unit digit is 2 and 2 power 10, unit digit is 4 and 2 power 11, the unit digit is 8. This continues for a various power numbers. So instead of calculating such a huge number, we can take 2 power of 6, where this cycles are repeated, that is unit digit cycles are repeated as 2, 4, 8 and 6. So this can be written as 2 to the power of 6 minus 4. We get 2 to the power of 2. So 2 to the power of 2 is nothing but the unit digit is 4. This should be used only when you are finding the unit digits and not the power of a number. This numbers 2, 4, 8 and 6 is repeating for every fourth cycle. So this is called as cyclicity 4. Now let's take other number as example. Take 2 power 13. Since it is a cyclicity of 4, divide this 13 with 4. 4 to the 8, 4 3s are 12 and the remainder is 1. And now put this remainder as a power, 2 to the power of 1. So the unit digit is 2. Check for the other number, 2 to the power of 6, 6 divided by 4, 4 ones are 4, the remainder is 2, 2 to the power of 2, which is equal to 4. So if you compare this and this, you get the values exactly. So for higher numbers, for cyclicity 4, divide the power with 4 and the remainder value, use it as a power and take the unit digit. Now let's find cyclicity 1, the number 0, 1, 5 and 6 is said to have a cyclicity 1. That means for any power, the value remains constant. 0 to the power of any number is 0 and 1 to the power of any number is 1 and 5 to the power of any power number will be 5, 6. These are all unit digits. You can check the above statement. 0 power 0 is 0 and 0 power 1 is 0. And 0 power anything is 0. So hence the condition is satisfied. It is cyclic 1. Next check the cyclicity for 1. 1 power 0, 1. 1 power 1, 1. And 1 power 2 is 1. This process also continues. Next check for 5. 5 power 1 is 5. 5 power 2 is 25. And 5 power 3 is 125. Next check for 6. 6 power 1 is 6. 6 square is 36 and 6 cube is 216. If you see, all the unit digit ends with a single number. So this is called as cyclicity 1. Let's solve an example based on this. 5 power 626 plus 6 power 820. For this value, you have to find the unit digit. So 5 power 626. So anything with the power 5, it is in cyclicity 1. And hence, its unit digit is also 5. And for 6, it is also cyclicity 1 and its unit digit is 6. So 5 plus 6 is 11. So here, 1 is the unit digit for this given value. Next is cyclicity 2. 4 and 9, these numbers have the cyclicity of 2. For example, 4 power 1 and 4 square. 4 power 1 is 4 and 4 square is 16. 4 power 3, its unit digit is 4 and 4 power 4, its unit digit is 6. And if you see for 4 to the power of 5 and 4 to the power of 6, this unit digit again becomes 4 and 6. This process continues for any number of values, and hence it is called as cyclicity too. You can observe here 4 with the odd power, you get the same value 4, and 4 with the even power, you get the value as 6. So remember this thing. Now let's solve example on that. So 4 to the power of 927, find the unit digit of this given number. So since it is an odd number, its unit digit will be 4, and 4 to the power of 2082. You can see this is an even number, and hence its unit digit will be 6. Now find the unit digit for 4 to the power 73 plus 4 to the power 74. So this has an odd power, so the value is 4, and this has an even power, so the value is 6. So these are the unit digits, which is equals to 10. So for the given number, 0 is the unit digit. Now let's see the cyclicity for 9. 9 power 1, 9 power 2, 9 ones are 9 and 9 nines are 81. 9 cube is equals to 729, and 9 to the power of 4 is equals to 6561. 9 to the power of 5, whose unit digit is 9, and 9 power 6 and unit digit is 1. You can see here 9 and 1 as a unit digit, this process keeps on repeating. So this 9 is also said to be cyclicity 2. Here also as 4, if 9 has odd power, the value of the unit digit is 9, and 9 has an even power, the value of its unit digit is 1. Now find the unit digit for the following: 9 power 826 plus 9 power 82 plus 9 power 63 plus 9 power 61. So this 826 power, it is an even number, so its unit digit is 1. For 82, again it is an even number, so the unit digit is 1. For 63, since it is an odd number, the unit digit is 9. And for 61 also it is 9. The addition of this gives the value 20. So here 0 is the unit digit for the given number. Cyclicity 4. The numbers 2, 3, 7 and 8 to the power of n. This numbers is said to have a cyclicity 4. The cyclicity of 2 we have seen in the earlier. The similar way, the cyclicity of 3, 7 and 8 remains. Let's take a number 3. 3 power 1 is 3, and 3 square is 9, and 3 cube is 27, and 3 to the power of 4 is 81. If you check for 3 to the power of 5, it is 243, and this continues. 3 power of 6, unit digit is 9, and 3 power of 7, it's 7, and 3 power of 8, it is 1. Here the numbers 3, 9, 7 and 1 goes on repeating for the 3. This will be the unit digits for 3 having any powers. For example, 2 to the power of 1037. You have to find the unit digit of this number. We know 2 is cyclicity of 4. So take the power 1037 and divide it with 4. Now remember the divisibility test for 4. We used to divide only the last two numbers. So take the last two numbers, that is 37. 4 nines are 36. That is 1 is the remainder. So 2 power 1037 is equals to 2 power 1, which is equals to 2 is the unit digit. Now let's take the other example, 7 power 5398. We know 7 has cyclicity 4, and therefore divide 5398 with 4. Use a divisibility test method, and 4 98. 4 2s are 8 and remainder is 1. 4 4s are 16 and remainder is 2. That means 7 power 5398 is equals to 7 to the power of 2, which is equals to 49, and 9 is a unit digit. Now let's solve your examples. Find the unit digit of 8 to the power of 1000. So we know 8 is a cyclicity 4. Therefore, divide 1000 with 4. 4 2s are 8, 4 5s are 20. The remainder is 0 here. So if the remainder is 0, you have to consider the cyclicity 4 itself. So 8 power 1000 is equals to 8 to the power of 4, which is equal to 8 into 8 into 8 into 8. We know 8 8s are 64 and 8 8s are 64. And here the unit digit is 4. Multiply these two unit digits, you get 16. So here 6 is the unit digit. Next, find the unit digit of 3 power 41 into 3 power 42 into 3 power 43. We know 3, 7 and 8 are all cyclicity of 4. Therefore, 3 power 41, which is equals to divide 41 by 4, the remainder is 1, and divide 42 by 4, the remainder is 2, and dividing 43 by 4, we get remainder as 3. Now let's write the unit digit for this terms, 3 into 9 into 2. So multiply this terms, we get the unit digit as 4. So 4 is the unit digit here. Find the unit digit of 121 to the power of 111 into 1287 to the power of 53. So we know, consider the last digit, that is 1 to the power of 111 into 7 to the power of 53. For any given large numbers, we are considering only the unit digit. That's why we are taking only 1 and 7. So we know 1 power of any number, use the value as 1. And 7 power 53. 7 is the cyclicity of 4. 53 divided by 4 gives the remainder 1. Therefore, the value is 7. So here 7 is the unit digit. Find the unit digit of 259 to the power of 148 minus 123 to the power of 43. Solve this equation. 9 power 148 minus 3 power 43. So we know 9 is the cyclicity of 2 and 3 is the cyclicity of 4. Since 9 is an even number, we get its value as 1. And 43 divided by 4 gives you the remainder 3. Therefore, here the unit digit of 3 cube is 7. So, subtraction of this gives minus 6. We don't use negative value. So, add with 10, we get the value as 4. So, here 4 is a unit digit. Now, let's discuss about the unit digits involved in factorial. So, let's take factorial is denoted by exclamatory mark. Can take 3 factorial, which is equals to 3 into 2 into 1. 4 factorial, which is equals to 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. 5 factorial, which is equals to 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. And 6 factorial, which is equals to 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. If you see the values, you get 3 factorial as 6 and 4 factorial as 24, 5 factorial as 120 and value of 6 factorial is 720. If you observe the value of 5 factorial, it is 120 and 6 factorial is 720. Because once you get 0 in the unit digit, if it is multiplied by any number, you get the unit digit. Find the unit digit of 1 factorial plus 2 factorial plus 3 factorial plus 4 factorial and so on till 1000 factorial. So we know from 5 factorial, all the unit digits are 0. So no need to worry about it. So consider only the first 4 factorials. So the unit digit of 1 factorial is 1, 2 factorial is 2, 3 factorial is 6, and 4 factorial is 4. So if you add all this, you get the unit digit as 3. Find the unit digit of 2 power 11 factorial. Means 2 power 11 factorial. We know from 5 factorial, the value of all the unit digit is 0. Therefore, we consider only till 4th factorial. So 2 power 4, which is equals to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, which is equal to 16. So here, 6 is the unit digit. Next, see, find the unit digit of 823 to the power of 123 factorial into 237 to the power of 234 factorial. Consider the unit digit 3 to the power of 123 factorial multiplied by 7 to the power of 234 factorial. So we know after 5, all the values are 0. So take 3 to the power of 4 into 7 to the power of 4. We know the value of 3 to the power of 4 is 1 into 7 to the power of 4 is 1. Which is equals to 1. So here 1 is the unit digit. Hope you like the session. Thank you, friends.